Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. As we get ready to begin our unit on fluids, let's take a moment to make sure we understand just how important the understanding of fluid behavior has been, not only to science, but to life as we know it. Do you happen to know what important event happened in December 1903? Here's a hint. Wilbur and Orville Wright made their first powered flight. Let's take a look and listen.
It was as recently as December 17, 1903, that Wilbur and Orville Wright made man's first sustained flights in an engine-driven airplane at Kitty Hawk, North Carolina, in the United States.
Once the Wright brothers proved to the world that manipulating the air was possible, humans took to the skies with powered flight and never looked back. Today, planes carry cargo and people all over the world, and it's hard to imagine our lives without this invention. In this unit, we'll see how the understanding of fluids allowed us to make this leap. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define and give examples of a fluid, explain buoyancy, and describe how air pressure affects flight. To understand the connection between fluids and airplanes, we first need to define what exactly is meant by the term fluid. Fluids consist of substances that can flow and usually include any matter in the liquid or gaseous state. From an earlier lesson on the states of matter, do you remember the properties of liquids and gases? Pause the video for a moment to record anything that comes to mind about these two states of matter. Earlier in the course, you learned that compared to solids, the particles making up liquids and gases have more freedom to move around, or flow, hence the name fluids. Both liquids and gases can change their shape to fill the container they are in, and gases can even expand or compress, changing their volume. Because air is a fluid, understanding how fluids behave in various situations was essential to getting the first planes off the ground. It turns out that physics was able to give our man-made wings a little help once we knew how to use fluid behavior to our advantage. Have you ever seen a hot air balloon? They can float effortlessly in the sky without even needing wings. How is this possible? It has to do with the difference between hot air and cold air and the resulting forces this temperature difference causes. Hot air balloons make use of the fact that hot air is less dense than cold air. This causes an upward force on the balloon known as buoyancy. In a later lesson in this unit, we'll take a closer look at how density and buoyancy are related, but an easy shortcut is to remember that all materials will naturally arrange themselves by density, with the more dense substance below the less dense substances. So if you have a low enough density, floating in the clouds is simply the result of physical laws at work. Hot air balloons have the advantage of low density to achieve flight, but even the first airplanes were made of materials far more dense than air. How is it possible that a metal contraption weighing thousands of pounds can lift off the ground and remain in the air? It has to do with another property of fluids, pressure. Anytime particles, including atoms and molecules, come into contact and exert forces, this creates pressure. Air will naturally always move from areas of higher pressure to areas of lower pressure. Wouldn't you? The desire to spread out and find a more relaxed space seems to be universal. The first aeronautical engineers discovered a way to manipulate these high and low pressure zones such that the air underneath the plane naturally wants to rise, creating an upward force that keeps the plane in the air. We'll see exactly how this is accomplished in a lesson all about flight later in this unit. For now, remember that it's all about fluids and how we can make use of their behavior for our own advantage. As we went through the lesson today, we saw how fluids affect the world around us. We can study buoyancy to learn how ships float in the ocean and how hot air balloons float in the sky. Then we can use the behavior of moving fluids to understand how the shape of an airplane wing allows it to defy gravity and soar across the globe. As we go through this unit on fluids, we'll study each of these topics in more detail, and you'll have a chance to build your own boat and plane in a hands-on lab. Until then, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. I'll see you next time. Hey.